the control booth. I am watching the Dallas Cowboys and Los Angeles Rams. In the first quarter, the Dallas Cowboys have picked up 3 points, and the Los Angeles Rams, nothing. There has been pretty much action in this game. This is December 19th, 1976, and with your host, Jeffrey Kuvin. And I hope you enjoy the football game.
Thank you. Yes, they gave up at 7:30.
Yes,
Hi, Dad.
I don't have a white foot. It's February 26, 1977, and it's my bat mitzvah party. And
everybody,
you want me to name everybody who's here?
Go!
Okay.
All right.
Stephanie,
this is what they do, each other, it's called brewing. So people don't play.
It's very nice.
It's like different from all other nights.
On all other nights, we either leaven bread or matzah. On this night, only matzah. On all other nights, we eat all kinds of herbs. Why on this night do we eat especially bitter herbs? On all other nights, we do not dip herbs at all. On this night, we dip them twice. On all other nights, we eat in ordinary manner. Why this night do we dine with special ceremony?
Four times the Torah bids us tell our children of the Exodus from Egypt. Four times the Torah repeats, and you shall tell your child on that day from this our tradition infers that there are different kinds of people. To each we respond in a different manner according to his question, his situation, and his needs. Chacham, that's the wise man. Ma hu omer, ma ha'edot, ve'achim ve'amashvachim asher
thank you. conscientious effort to back this school and your students to make it what it is. So we want you to care for this evening. You're certainly a main part of the team. We have ordered a little bit of rain to stop reading the century computer there for a while. We're glad that it stopped and we can get off of it. It is fantastic. Fantastic. Here, rather than going all through the elementary building, once more, after the program, all
children too aggressive. The County Council of Parent Teacher Association held a seminar. The speakers included psychiatrists, school officials, and media representatives. Each urged the parents to be more discreet in the programs they allow their children to watch.
Violent children is what our century is producing here in America. This is not true in other countries.
You think being more selective in what you watch is the answer?
Yes, definitely. Being more selective, knowing when to turn the television sets on and off, and having parents watch television with their children and explain certain things to them.
Great aggression. I don't say we all stem from violence on TV, but certainly this is one of the qualities that helps violence perpetuate itself in the country.
Similar groups across the country have already had an effect on the television industry. Networks have revised their fall programs to contain less violence, and several larger sponsors have removed their commercials for the more violent shows. This is Carol Myers, Eyewitness 12.
Sharks, thousands of them.
Has witnessed 11,000 television murders by the time he reaches the age of 14. Think what this means. For a child to see death over and over again, year after year. Children are likely to learn and remember new forms of aggressive behavior by watching this kind of violence presented on the mass media.
Evening, welcome to our town. Tonight, the Palm Beach Parents Teacher Association joins the National PTA in their fight against violence on television. Recently, a Palm Beach PTA survey of 3,000 citizens revealed that 95% of them object to television violence. Many of them were present in today's public hearing.
To real-life tragedy. Children become desensitized to real tragedy. Dr. Aaron, professor of psychology at the University of Illinois, says that at this time it can be stated with utmost confidence that media violence has an adverse effect on the behavior of young people. Excessive exposure to media violence increases the likelihood that a child will behave violently throughout his life. Children learn from television that violence is an acceptable problem-solving method. The National PTA has conducted 8 hearings throughout the country and is documenting the testimony. They've also come out with some ideas, which we'll hear about later as a summary. The PTA is not interested in censoring programs, but is launching a campaign to pressure television networks to reduce the number of violent programs and to improve their overall quality. It feels that parents have the responsibility to monitor television to ensure that programs are suitable for their children. ABC Program Director Fred Silverman admits that the PTA's involvement was a factor in ABC's reduction of violence on television for next fall. The main purpose of this seminar is to raise the consciousness of our community. If people, especially parents, become involved and aware of what their children are watching and the effect of television on their lives, we will feel satisfied that we have raised the level of consciousness. We would like you to give mature thought to this enormous problem. We would like you to consider the impact television violence has on our children. We would like you to consider the impact television violence has on society's behavior. We would like you to become actively involved in this protest against increased violence, because if we don't, then surely we have only ourselves to blame. The first speaker will be Dr. Robert Alton.
I think that in order to make this meeting useful, since it's being rather highly publicized, let me say what the real problem turns out to be. Why, in the face of the known damage, constantly increasing mountainous evidence that children are being negatively affected by the violence of television, to an obscene extent, or with some concern going on with morality, why does it keep on appearing? The real obvious answer is itself, and that, in a certain sense, there is